just a bit over 3,700 pounds of very interesting, unique kind of offering coming into us down here at Advantage One RV today. This is a little 17-foot box StarCraft kind of toy hauler, hybrid, weekender, getawayer, real unique critter. What really sets it apart for me is not just the fact that it's got this ramp door on the back, it's a 7-foot wide, easy towing, lightweight little camper. It's what's going on the opposite side. Because of this right here, a single individual side, what I'm going to call bonus bed. I don't really consider this camper a hybrid. I think it's a mini toy hauler first and foremost, but that is going to give it some unique kind of sleeping solutions. One of the things you're not seeing overtly, I want to make sure you're aware of, is it does have a roll down screen wall on the back. It's one of the nice ones that's on a track too. So it's not like one of those tent walls that constantly flaps in your face and is a pain in the butt to put back up. This seating bench right here, very, very flexible. As you see, obviously we can seat and face toward the entertainment center. It can fold down into a sleeper, which gives this camper four separate sleepers. Very kind of cool in case, I don't care if you got a small family or if it's just like you and a friend or a couple friends and, you know, nobody wants to like feel weird about sleeping in the same bed at night, you know, saying, hey buddy, we're not European, we don't sleep in the same beds. Okay, well then don't. And obviously that can fold up to, you know, create your loading space. I do want to make a quick mention of the fact that nothing's missing from this camper. Like, you don't see that mattress there right now, but the mattress is just up front. The previous owners kept it on the main master bed when they traveled, so they didn't have to worry about losing anything. Actually, previous owners even added a tire pressure monitoring system as well as a power tongue smart jack, which can be programmed to remember the height of your hitch ball, basically, for kind of easier hitching and gitching. I don't know what gitching is, but it's easier now. TV's on a swing arm for some easy viewing. The kitchen space, you know, all of the facilities, I guess you'd say, in the camper, they're simple, basic, effective, you know? Front bunk up here, I like the fact that the nose on this RV isn't severely tapered. If you did have a little kid, I do still think that this still functions well as a good sleeping space. But what's nice is how this folds up out of the way. So if you don't need that thing, you know, you don't got to worry about it. Again, the hybrid mattress is on top of the original mattress. That is a roughly a full bed. I'll see if I can dig up some measurements. I believe it is around 4 foot wide and about 74 inches long. That might be 80 inches wide, but or 80 inches long this way, and between 4 or 5 feet kind of that way, if that helps you. Well, again, try to get you some specific measurements. Bathroom here, like everything else, you know, it is simple, it is basic, it is compact, but what more do you really need? You got a spot here if you need to, you got a shower on the left, and a separate shower pan, not a what's called a wet bath where the toilet and the shower are kind of one in the same. I'll look here at it in, I guess you call it garage mode, travel mode. This is going to be something like if you got a kayak, you could run a kayak right down the floor of this thing. You see the D-rings through the flooring here. A couple of bicycles, e-bikes, dog crates. A lot of different ways you could use this one. And again, if you don't care for, need, want that side bonus bed, literally nothing says you have to use it. When you fold it up, it's just a hard side camper. And what's actually cool for security purposes, those have separate cam latch key locks, you know, so that people can't get into your camper as easy, basically. Now, like I said, up on the front here, the original manual tongue jack was swapped out for something that's probably silly overkill. This is a smart jack. This is something like Rockwood does on their high-level signature series. And basically, it can be set to remember the hitch height of your vehicle for easy, hitching and gitching. You know what I just realized? That double propane tank system, that is a nice feature. That means that if one of the tanks goes empty, you know, you don't have a break in service. You can just swap it out as required. Simple side mount solar bright plug, help keep the batteries topped off when you are away from the parks. There's the original tongue jack, because like I said, none of the original factory stuff is missing. All the folks did was add to it. In case you're curious what's in that box right there, that is an outside RVQ grill. Now, the RV looks to be well-maintained, but again, used. It's sort of like, you know, if you bought a pre-owned vehicle a couple years old with a couple thousand miles on it, it's gonna show where somebody else drove it and maybe a shopping cart bumped it. And that's kind of, I guess, the message that I have for you here. And that is that it's not perfect, but it ain't bad. I mean, I don't see anything here that really concerns me too greatly. And what I mean is there's a couple surface blemishes. Like, it looks like maybe a tree branch did a little Christopher Walken tap dance down the side of this thing. And a couple of those stripes are a little bit sun faded. I don't believe that was their original color over there. Also, I nearly call this one the StarCraft Arone because, you know, AR1, Arone. It wasn't funny. That's why I didn't do it. Don't yell at me. galvanized steel protective wheel well and aluminum wheels kind of round us out. And overall, guys, I think she's pretty solid. Roof is walkable. You see a spare tire on the back right there. Yeah, I hope you never need it, but nice that you got it. A lot of toy haulers in this size, by the way, they don't mount the spare tire. You have to go, like, rolling it around to get it out of the way the whole time. So if you like something that's a little quirky, different, left to center, well, that's probably why you're watching me. But if you like a camper that's quirky, different, left to center, it's probably why you're going to like this one. So give us a call down here at A1 RV, and we'll get you camping. Doesn't matter if you got a trade, doesn't matter if you need financing, you need hitching, we do everything. Whether this is going to be your first one or your last one, we'll take care of you. So take care, stay safe, have fun, and have an A1 day, everyone.